Do you understand, Mary? What I'm saying is that why are you struggling with yourself when you are already saved? All I have to do is realize the brass ring is there and say, oh, I see. It's keeping me from salvation. It's making me think I'm the one that has to struggle with myself, have to save myself, have to damn myself. See? And you're getting all those ideas. They're all negative. Those are not your ideas. They're not your thoughts. It's the thing inside you. It's a thing, but it's no thing. It's a thing. Like, you know, gravity is a thing, but a no thing. Yet to be things. It's very simple. God is, well, I don't know about a thing, but he's not nothing. He's spiritual. The spiritual creates the first. If you're going to create something spiritual, you have to create a no thing, gravity, yet to be a thing. It's relativity, spirit. My spirit. Well, my spirit is. It's. I can't tell you what it is. My spirit is not me. My spirit is. It is. God. That's the only way. Can I look at God and look inward? I can't turn my eyes. Spiritualized back in, I can't see. All I know that he created the universe, then he created me. You know, I'm a little self-centered, but of course he created you too. But he created me, and then I have the opportunity to listen to him or listen to the other fellow, and that's the choice, because God can't create love. That's the only thing he can't create, because he's got to give you a choice. So he has to create evil too. So we want to talk about that. Actually, God creates evil. He permitted evil to happen. The angels, if there were angels, he had to give them an opportunity to love him or not, right? And if not, get banished. But the angels are spirits; they don't die. So now, what you're dealing with is. That hidden war that went on before you were created, the first man was created. And so the first man's created, there's evil. He's a spiritual person in a corporeal body. This is a piece of architecture, is unbelievable. It's one thing to create a spirit. You can create a spirit. You got a spirit inside you, all of a sudden it appears a spirit. But the spirit will do all kinds of good things or bad things. See, so, but it has to start, it has to be the ultimate relative. You have to have the ultimate relative. I wrote a book, Finding God in Physics, Einstein's Missing Relative. He was talking about relativity. Mm-hmm. See, relative to you, I'm tall. Relative to a 10-foot tall person, I'm small. And then it looks funny, because suddenly I look small and next to you I feel, or next to a little kid, I'm tall. But that kid will look at a big fella, 3 feet taller than me, and they'll see me as a wimp. It's a whole different viewpoint suddenly. See, so it's all a matter of different viewpoints. It's called relativity. And so there's always has to be a relative, something to create, that's not matter, that is not nothing, but something, super something that is not, unbeknown to us, has created everything. See, and so, coming back to me, I've been created, I've learned, I've discovered, or I've known, without a whole lot of words, that of myself, I haven't got a direction. I cannot give myself words. I cannot give myself positive thinking. I wouldn't know what thinking to choose. See? So, whatever thinking is coming from, it has to come from some being, some thing, which is a very bad word, but I don't know how to say it, some spiritual dimension which is intangible, unbelievable, incredible to most people who have no faith. But I know that that's happened. There's a spirit in me that knows that I have no, well, myself, I can do nothing, but I'm the vehicle through which it happens. But the soul has to be involved. The soul is given to me as the extension on earth as it is in heaven. So in my earthy realm, in my earthy corporeal body, I'm living in there, coexisting, one within the other, right? So I know that I cannot create my own purpose. The purpose is, but he doesn't tell me what it is. He only gives me a little piece at the time, with like the lamp under your feet. I just know that I do that, and I know I shouldn't do that, and I shouldn't do that. How else would you do it? That's ridiculous. And the two extremes are ridiculous. I may see them, but I only do this one. And I keep doing that, and I keep following the impulse. And the impulse is becoming a real person. But if you follow your impulses, you also become an unreal person. So you take the spirit of evil takes shape in you, and it will live in your body and drive out your soul, kill your spirit, kill your relationship with God. But if there's any, which I can't explain, it will kill most people. Most people have never lived, see, and never will live. They just die. They just go straight to but they die. They never draw the same breath as long as they live. But there's something about you that's still alive. That's all it takes to believe the truth that you are forgiven. That's all you have to do to know that you cannot save yourself. But the other fellow will damn you for trying. See? It's damned if you try and damned if you don't. And if you stop trying, it'll laugh at you too. See? It'll trick you every single time. So, you want a purpose? You want a purpose for life? Believe what I just said.